Hello students, let us start with a new chapter. Chapter's name is Algorithm and Complexity. Students, you must have solved a particular problem or you must have written a particular program of a particular question. So different students, they write their program in different ways. It means they use their own logic in order to solve that problem. For example, if you are asked to find the LCM of two given numbers, maybe one student has used a particular set of logical steps in order to find out LCM of two numbers, and another student could have used different set of instructions or different set of logical steps in order to solve or find out the LCM of two numbers. It means we can use different algorithm. So algorithm means a particular set of logical steps, how to solve a particular problem or how to write a particular program. Programming language could be anything. It could be Python, it could be C++ or C or Java, etc. So irrespective of what programming language you are using, you can use a particular algorithm, means a particular set of steps. Maybe algorithm of one student may be more efficient than another student. Now in the next topic, we'll be talking about what is the algorithm or how can it be defined, and the complexity of that algorithm, means how complex an algorithm is. Maybe an algorithm have used just three steps and there could be another algorithm which has used 10 steps or more than 10. Now let's move on to the next topic. What is algorithm? You can see algorithm is a logical set of instructions to be executed in a certain order to solve a problem and get the desired output. Now, as I have already told you, an algorithm can be implemented in more than one programming language. From the data structure point of view, following are some important categories of algorithm. In class 11th, you must have written the program in order to search for an item from a list or from a tuple or from a dictionary, or you must have arranged the different data items in a particular order. So there is the sort algorithm. Similarly, you can have insert algorithm, update algorithm, delete algorithm, etc. So these are the different types of algorithm: search, sort, insert, update, delete. So these are the important algorithm that we keep on using these things in our program. You can see the example. In the example, this is the example of algorithm. Algorithm to find the sum of any two numbers. Now there are seven steps and this is the logical steps following which you can find out and print the sum of any two numbers. In step one, we start the program, then in the step two, declare three integers A, B and C, then we define value of A and B. In step four, we add value of A and B. In step 5, we store the sum of A and B to a third variable C, and then in step 6, we print C, and 7, we stop. So this is the logical set of steps, how to find the sum of two numbers, if the numbers are defined in two variables A and B. So this is one example of algorithm. Similarly, you can define algorithm for various other programs or for various other problems. Now, we have computational complexity. Now, students, we need to understand complexity. Complexity means how complex an algorithm is. Supposing an algorithm solve a particular problem in 5 steps. There could be another algorithm which solve the same problem in 50 steps. There could be another one which solve the same problem in more than 100 steps. It means what? Complexity of the algorithm is increasing. The most simple or the most efficient algorithm will be the algorithm which is solving that particular problem only in 5 steps, right? And the algorithm which is solving the same problem in more than 100 steps, that will be the most complex and hence least efficient. We can define computational complexity. It is a field from computer science which analyzes algorithms based on the amount resources required for running it. Means how much space it takes and how much time it consumes. The amount of required resources varies based on the input size. So the complexity is generally expressed as a function of n, where n is the size of the input. So complexity largely depends upon the input. Means what is the value of n which we are passing as an argument or as a parameter to a particular function or method or in a program. Now you can see, when analyzing an algorithm, we can consider time complexity and space complexity. So complexity is of two types. Time complexity, it is concerned with time, means an algorithm is taking how much time. Then space complexity, in terms of space, means memory space, how much memory a particular algorithm will take in order to solve a problem. Now let's come to the time complexity. Time complexity is the computational complexity that describes the amount of time it takes to run an algorithm, which is estimated by counting the number of elementary operations performed by the algorithm. So time consumed will depend upon how many number of elementary operations will be performed by a particular algorithm. So number of steps or number of operations. Then we have space complexity, as I have already explained, is basically the amount of memory space required to solve a problem in relation to the input size. So be it memory space or time consumption by an algorithm, it all largely depends upon the input size. Now let us come to the categorization of complexity. We can categorize the time complexity of an algorithm in 3 categories. You can see best case, average case, and worst case. Let us understand what it means. Now we are giving an example. Suppose we have the following unsorted list. You must have done the list in Python. So for example, this is the list having these numbers 1, 5, 3, 9, 2, 4, 6, 7, 8. And we need to find the index of a value in this list using linear search. Means we need to search for an item, the position of that item or index of that item. Now there could be 3 cases, means 3 types of efficiency of an algorithm. One is best case, then average case, and then worst case. Now you can see the best case. Best case, this is the complexity of solving the problem for the best input. Now in this example, in our example, the best case would be to search for the value 1, because value 1, you can see value 1 is at the first position. Since this is the first value of the list, it would be found in the first iteration. Means the algorithm will need to execute only one operation in order to find the position of one. So this would be the best case for that algorithm. Then average case, this is the average complexity of solving the problem. We can say that the average case would be when we are searching for some value in the middle of the list. For example, the value 2, you can see here the value 2, it is just around the middle of the list. Okay, now in this the algorithm will have to operate 1, 2, 3, 4. Only 5 operations will be executed by the algorithm. Okay, so in the best case only one operation, in the average case there would be only 5 operations. Okay, with respect to this particular case. Now worst case would be, this is the complexity of solving the problem for the worst input of size n. In our example, the worst case would be to search for the value 8, because value 8 is just at the end. So the algorithm will have to traverse through all the elements 1, 5, 3, 9, 2, 4, 6, 7, then it will find the position of 8. Now it will have to go through all the elements. So this would be the worst case for the algorithm in terms of number of operations. So these are the three categories of the efficiency of an algorithm: best case, average case, and worst case. Whenever we find the complexity of an algorithm with respect to n, then we always find the worst case. Now, big O notation. What is big O notation? Big O notation is used to classify algorithms according to how their running time or space requirements grow as the input size grows. So depending upon the number of or the value of n, how the running time or space requirement will also grow. It depends upon the efficiency of the algorithm, right? So this efficiency we can denote by using a notation called big O notation. So this notation categorizes the functions according to their growth rate. Different functions with the same growth rate may be represented using the same big O notation. So in the next video, we will study what is or how can we find the big O notation for a particular algorithm. So we will take different examples in the next video, and in those examples we will find the efficiency or the degree of complexity by using big O notation, so that we can understand how complex an algorithm is. Thank you.